What is going on, fellow fans of Clash of Clans? Thank you guys so much for your support on this series and, of course, for stopping by, spending a few minutes of your day with me. It, of course, is your host, Galadon. And yes, no Cash Clash happening again. Don't worry, I will get to the 0% defenses in just a moment. But first of all, I just wanted to say thank you so much for over 10,000 likes on the last video when I only asked for 6,900. Now, some people are thinking this whole like thing is kind of controversial because you think that I'm just going to keep raising it so that eventually we can't possibly get there, or maybe not enough people are going to watch. So I tell you guys what, we're going to do it differently this time. We are going to let Alexa decide. So Alexa, tell me a random number between 1 and 20,000.
A random number between 1 and 20,000 is 6,969.
Well, you heard it here first, trolled by Alexa. 6,969 likes is what we need for there to be an episode 5. So I'm not necessarily going to keep raising it every time, but I would like to keep people interested, and I want to make sure you guys are still enjoying it. Like I said, it doesn't have to get a ton of views, just needs to get the likes, that interaction from you, the hardcore viewers that really enjoy the series. So thank you in advance for making the like button happy by depressing it. Now, today's episode is sponsored. It is a very special sponsor. It's the Pancreatic Cancer Foundation. And this is the third most deadly cancer out there, often called the forgotten cancer, an 8% survival rate. That's right, out of 100 deployed barbarians, only 8 are actually going to survive pancreatic cancer. So you can help raise the rate. There is a link down in the description. Click on that. Anything you can donate helps and goes a long way for people who are affected by this awful disease. And Giga Infernos, there's not much we can do about that. Okay, so let's go ahead and let me tell you, first of all, I honestly thought that we would do like one episode on Town Hall 2, one episode on Town Hall 3, one on Town Hall 4, one on Town Hall 5, and then maybe things would slow down at 6. But man, there is a lot of stuff to upgrade, even way down here. So, you know, we're being patient. I am playing in spurts, and I guess that's part of what makes Clash of Clans so popular for so long, is the fact that it's easy to put down. It's easy to play for a little bit and walk away, and that has been a big change for, of course, Legend League players with Operation Blue Skies. But that's a whole nother subject. But okay, back to the little guys. That's us, the lower Town Hall levels. Definitely, if you can, get into a clan that has at least a few big donators, because the baby dragon on offense and on defense goes a long, long ways. In fact, other than spamming a few troops in behind, maybe putting together a good base to try to protect your resources and just upgrading everything, there's just not that much to Clash of Clans this early on. But then again, that's the point, right? You try to get players hooked, get them invested in building their base. They take pride in it. They feel like there's some sort of progression, and they continue and they want to keep going. And there's always that carrot in front of the donkey. You know, the idea that there's something just around the corner. Oh man, I can't wait to unlock, you know, baby dragons myself, or maybe it's just dragons. Maybe it's just unlocking wizards because you saw them at the beginning of the game. There's always something just ahead, just out there, that looks amazing. Now, for me right now, it's the next builder. Now, the third builder, I believe, is... where is he? Hold on. The third builder is out here somewhere. Here he is. He's 500 gems. Okay, so now I've got 400 gems. I am incredibly close. In fact, if I just clear a few obstacles, I could easily get to about 420 gems or so. Just this one time, you guys, it's only 99 cents, okay? It's less than a dollar, okay? I'm not going to, okay, fine, I'm kidding. We're gonna do it the real way, okay? The genuine way, which for the most part just means clearing obstacles, okay? There's probably a few upgrades we're gonna do in the meantime. We're gonna clear a bunch of obstacles. In fact, this is not the, this is exactly how you upgrade Town Halls 3, 4, 5. That's not what this series is about. Okay, now I will try to cover some of that stuff, but for me, this is just more playing how I want to play. And the cool thing about Clash of Clans, one more time, is that early on, it doesn't really matter. You can't really screw up the game super badly way down here. Now, I did get promoted. That was primarily because of my defenses. I got up to bronze too because, well, the baby dragon on defense is just killing it. So let's take a look at some 0% attacks. You heard me right, 0%, and these were players not dropping Not dropping trophies. You can see they are trying to attack. They are trying to gain loot. And, well, the baby dragon working overtime. Check that one out. Okay, 0% damage. They got, what, like 5, 10% of my resources? Here we go again. Check out the army of giants. Just the baby D. In again, this guy looks like he was just going after my town hall primarily, going for trophies. No, denied. Not a single building. That's right, 0%. One more time. I love his name. It had noob in it, so there you go. Okay, again, mostly just upgrading storages. And we haven't even put the lab down yet, so we've got to do that. Get the lab down, and then we can finally upgrade troops. Again, like I said, this is something I would normally suggest to do sooner, but I'm just having fun. And again, it doesn't matter. At town halls, you know, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, that's where these things are going to matter a little bit more. Right here, I say just go out and have fun. Upgrade your barbs or whatever you want. Maybe it's your goblins, maybe it's your archers. Here we are going to start on those level 2 barbs, and like I said, there's so many of these upgrades that, you know, force you to really leave the game alone because it's so easy to get loot right now. I've noticed the massive amounts of loot out there, even at Town Halls 3 and 4, it's crazy. They're just sitting out there waiting to be taken, so most of it's like attack once or twice, do your upgrades, get your builders busy, and then move on. You know, go do something else, come back in an hour. And if you're like me, you could even sit down and set a timer. You know, have Siri or Alexa set a timer for you so that you know exactly when to come back. And that's a little bit more efficient. Although, I have to admit, with the Clash of Clans update stuff happening, I really haven't had a chance to play No Cash Clash as much as I'd like to. So, you know, we're doing it. I promise we will get more chances to make this a more regular series once the update has dropped and kind of the hype has kind of cooled down a little bit from that, because it is going to be crazy. We all know that for sure. So, all right, here, just a little bit of strategy, taking out the air defense right there early and then using the baby dragon to get in and take out the mortar, although I probably could have waited a little bit longer. There it goes. That's the primary worry that you have to watch out for as a ground attacker this low, is that mortar. The splash damage will kill you. And this is one of my first 3 stars. I know you guys were also in the comments saying you're upset because I wasn't finishing bases off. So here you go. 32 trophies and 3 stars, getting every last drop of loot. Looking good. And the storage is starting to get better. You know, now we're holding over 100K with our storages. So we can definitely, like I said, have a lot of loot in order to do. You can see, I mean, some of these upgrades are super crazy cheap and we've got way too much loot. So there's not as much attacking happening yet. It's more just feeling like the progress is super fast. And speaking of fast progress, let's go ahead and accelerate the removal of a bunch of obstacles, because right now our goal is that 3rd builder. So on our way to 500 gems for the 3rd builder, a great time to remind you about the creator code. Have you not used this yet? If you get a chance, it would be really greatly appreciated if you could drop down to the settings, click on more settings, scroll to the bottom, click on enter code for creator boost, and type in Galadon. What does this do, you ask? Well, it costs you nothing, but it sends about 5% of anything you spend on Clash of Clans during the next 7 days. You have to renew it every 7 days. It sends it to me. Now, I haven't gotten any money yet, but, and it's a big but, I am giving a big chunk of it back to you guys. 10% going to charity, 10% going back to you, the viewers. So I have no idea. Again, it could be 50 bucks, it could be 50,000, but look for the giveaways starting really soon as we get something back. Now, I'm guessing it's closer to $50 than 50,000, just saying. But we don't know. I honestly don't know. If 4 million players put in creator code Galadon and buy the gold pass, I get $1 million. Okay? If I get $1 million, I'm giving $100,000 to charity immediately, and I'm giving $100,000 away to viewers like you. Can you imagine? That's nuts. Oh my gosh, that would be crazy. So let's do it, you guys. Let's get together and do this, and it's possible. I mean, you know, crazier things have happened. I would love to be out there in my live streams, in videos, giving away. I'd be like the Mr. Beast of Clash of Clans. It would be epic. All right, make it happen. Okay. Okay. Speaking of making it happen, look what I just made happen. That's right, 501 gems. It took me a couple of days here. This was like farming and then removing obstacles and then farming a little bit more because they're pretty expensive over there. So let's go ahead and ignore the packages. Those were from like last week or 2 weeks ago anyway. And here it is. Okay. The magical, mystical, much revered, much awaited 3rd builder hut. Now, where did we, put him. Okay, I'm just going to just stick him over here by the town hall. Little town hall protection right there. And now, miracle upon miracle, we have three builders excited about that. And that's really going to speed things up. I mean, again, of all the pieces of advice I could give, get that third builder as soon as you can. The next builder is going to take much longer to get. So we're going to have to be happy with three for now. And you know what else I would be happy with? 6,969 likes. Thanks a lot, Alexa. But yeah, that's going to be epic. If you guys can do that, I am still having fun. I promise you, not slowing down anytime soon and also not spending any money. It's no cash clash. And you are true Galifam members for sticking around all the way to the end of the episode. Now get out there, make the best of your day, be kind to be villainous, and I'll see you all back here again tomorrow for more No Clash Full Attacks.
Galadon, how can you do it, man? How can you play this game without spending gems? It makes no sense at all. None at all.